Who am I kidding? I'm dramatic a lot of the time. Why is there a fly dying on my desk? I don't know. But yeah. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, my haul of May. I needed to think again. So, yeah, it's quite a lot. Now that I have everything in front of me, I thought I didn't have a lot this month, but apparently I do. So yeah, go figure. I'm very dramatic today, as I am sometimes. Well, who am I kidding? I'm dramatic a lot of the time, but that does not really matter. I do really like it. I have an eyeshadow palette on my eyes, obviously, that I will touch on a little bit later in the video. I will leave my monthly haul playlist underneath the cards and down in the description box, or maybe just down in the description box and on my end screen. I think I will do that. The products I will mention today, I will kind of go over very quickly because this video is kind of linked to my review roundup, my monthly review roundup videos that I started last month, because I sometimes just have too little newer favorites to make a video about it, you know. So yeah, I decided to do it a little bit differently. So the review roundup of this month, which is then the month of May, the May products that I'm going to talk about today, will be online in July, so that I have had time enough to test everything out. So what you will see this month in my this month in my monthly review will be the month of April. Yes, I will leave that playlist down below as well. But let's just, you know, get into it. I will link the list all the products that I have hauled down in the description box. I will probably link some, but not all, just so you know. Let's start with skincare, because I have some skincare here. Let's start with this, which is from the Inky List. It's from their Peptide Moisturizer. And actually the component is about the size of the box. And it is, you take off the cap, it's like kind of like Drunk Elephant, you know, the packaging that they have. You kind of squeeze the top down and then stuff comes out. Yes, I know what I said, I know how it sounds. That's just the way though. That kind of means that the product is very nicely packaged and no air can get in it, and it is very good against, you don't have to dig your fingers in. That was what I wanted to say. I don't know if I can get everything out though, so I have to try that. So far, I really like the cream. It's nice and hydrating, and that is something that I am looking for as well. So I like it. I'm also kind of looking for a different sunscreens. The favorite sunscreen that I had for underneath my makeup was from Nivea, and I am using that one up, but I'm also kind of searching for different ones. So I'm going to go to our drugstore's own brands, because they are cruelty free. I have here one from Trekpleister, which is the SPF 50 face anti-aging sun fluid. Yeah, it's nice. It's nice. Unfortunately, it is scented. So downstairs, I forgot to bring the box up, but I also got from Kruidvat their sun fluid for the face for sensitive skin, which isn't scented. So there's that. So I'm trying these out. They work, you know, and that is, if I'm spending all that money to make this nice, you kind of need to protect it with the sunscreen. So there's that. Then let's go to the only Makeup Revolution product that I have this month. Wow, really? And that's a lip mask from iHeart Revolution. This is in the scent Mango Smoothie. I also have the cherry one that's downstairs that I really, really like. I like these a lot. Okay. Let's next go to AliExpress then. Let's show you this. This is a cloth cotton round thingy that I ordered from AliExpress, because I want to stop using the ones that you throw away, you know. They work. One side is a little bit softer, the other side is a little bit more, almost a little bit more scratchy. They work. Wash them on the boil wash, so 60 degrees Celsius and up, to get them as clean as possible, because yeah, it does stain, especially my waterproof makeup that I have on. It stains the thingies, but I don't really mind it, because they are just for me anyway. But I think they're very, very nice. I will leave the link to the seller down below. They all can also be used for when you're lactating. Just so you know. So yeah, the other thing that I got from AliExpress is makeup sponges. This is a bag of 20 sponges. They're nice. They're makeup sponges, they're nice. What I do usually do, if I'm going to use new sponges, when I wet them and I'm like, they are a little bit stiffer, I throw them in the washing machine. Don't use fabric softener then. I use cleaning vinegar. Yeah, vinegar specifically to clean. You know, I use it as fabric softener a lot anyway. Just a tiny amount and it works wonders. So, I don't know, that's how I also deep clean my makeup sponges every once in a while. Okay, let's next go to kind of the regular stuff. What I'm very happy about is that Primark opened again this month. Yay! So I could get my favorite falsies again, which are the London styles. So I bought a bunch. I think I have 4 packs and a set in use. Just so you know. I also got a few of the Kylies, but last week when I was there, they didn't have the Kylies. So I have 1 set in use, I think, and I have 2 backups. So when they are in store again, I will grab another one pair because I just love those styles. The London ones are my most natural ones. Well, not really, but you know. And the Kylie ones are nice and spiky and open. I have a pair here as well that I have in use. Never mind. They're nice and open and spiky and I like them. So yeah, I don't have them on today. I have a different pair on today. But yeah, I also got 2 blushes. The Floral Days blushes. This is in the color Bouquet. I haven't used them yet. They are matte blushes. But this is Bouquet, which is very, very cutesy. Yes. It's a little bit more pink, I think. Or is it a rosy color? Let's see. I don't remember. The other one is called Bloom. Oh yeah. And that one is a little bit more orangey. So this is the color Bloom and this is the color Bouquet. Again, I haven't used them yet. They did feel, they also look kind of powdery. Basically, I haven't used them yet. That's it. Okay, and then what I also got at Primark is a green duo glue, because they also sell duo glue there. I thought let's try the green one because it has a brush, a very tiny brush tip applicator, and I like this one a lot. This I think is without latex. Usually I don't like glue without latex. This one though, I really do like. It dries very, very quickly. When you paint it on, it's a little bit like a bluish iridescent. And then when it is almost clear, you're either just on time or too late. But putting on my falsies now is a lot quicker than with the eyelure glue. Let me just say that. Okay, let's next go to... Let's go to Ofra, because I can. So I got a bunch of Ofra stuff. I got... First, I ordered the Samantha March collab because it arrived at Boozy Shop. It is also at Beauty Bay. And to be honest with you, Beauty Bay is cheaper. About 6 euros cheaper than Boozy Shop. But I got these on sale anyway, so I kind of paid the same amount. But yeah, so I have the bronzer duo in River and the blush duo in Chiclet. I didn't get the highlighter because I didn't have a highlighter from Ofra yet. And I didn't know if I would like the shade. These are so pretty. So pretty. I did use the bronzer today. I didn't use the blush today. But ever since I got these, I am using them. Just... That maybe that says enough. I did want to try one of the Ofra highlighters because I loved those two products so much. So what did I actually order? I ordered the highlighter All of the Lights, because you have 4 of their most popular shades in here. You get Pillow Talk, Star Island, Blissful and Rodeo Drive. I have Pillow Talk on my face today and I have Star Island in the inner corner. And Pillow Talk is maybe a tad too light. But I can just make it work. So yeah. I also ordered another big liquid lipstick from them in the color Verona. Which I have used. I also got 2 minis gift with purchases. This is the color Mina and this is the color Tuscany. I haven't used these yet. So yeah, I have 3 minis now. I like the minis. I just like minis. What can I say? So I have those, yes. If you were on the fence about her collaboration, don't be. Very, very pretty. I do have to say, the bronzer, if you are a lot darker than me, I can make it work now. I think that if you have a medium skin tone, I don't know if it will show up a lot. Just saying. But then again, Samantha is about my skin tone, maybe a little bit lighter, so it's not weird that she came out with that that shade, you know. I also wanted to try, because I ordered from Douglas some things, I wanted to try this one as well, which is the mini Bahama Mama from the Balm. And it is just so cute. Look how cute. I'm actually looking for kind of an alternative for my Maybelline City Bronzer. Because Maybelline isn't cruelty free, but this is such a good color. So I'm kind of seeing if I can find a replacement for that. Is it a replacement for that? Is it? Oh, it could very be. No, the Bahama Mama one looks a little bit deeper almost. So here's the difference. It is the same tone though, that cooler bronzer that I really like. So yeah, that was that. Then I also got, let's do this one, the ABH Eye Primer. I actually thought Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner was raving about it, but she's raving about the Natasha Denona one. Well, she's also a woman, so yeah. I know that Anki really likes it, and I have to say, I like it so far as well. I use it 3 times now, so not a lot, but I do really like it. The only thing though, store it like this, because if you store it like this, and you twist the cap off, shit comes out. Yes, so yeah, I will keep on playing with that and update you later on. I also got a few foundations, so what I wanted to do was, because I went cruelty free, I will link the video where I kind of explain a little bit more about that underneath the cards. My favorite foundation is the NARS foundation. That's so, so pretty. NARS isn't cruelty free. It's hella expensive as well. So I was already looking for a dupe. And then I heard, I think it was from Shan XO, I believe. She said it was a dupe and I wanted to try it. So I got it. I got the shade 110 Neutral, which is a very nice match. I have it on my face today. If you want to know my first impression, it is coming because I filmed it. If it is online already, I will link it. Otherwise, it is coming. I just don't know when. I have a lot of videos filmed that I want to get up. But I also wanted to get these. Why? Because the Dior foundation that I have, the face and body that I got, I gave to my friend. It was a perfect color match for her, but I really liked the texture. I liked the finish. Then I remembered that Essence has something similar. So I got these again, the Essence hashtag InstaPerfect. I didn't really know which color to get, so I got the color 30 and 50 because they didn't have 40. And I think that 50 was a good shade for me. I know I used it in a video, but I don't remember which one because I filmed a lot. So yeah, I am going to, I did do a foundation review when these just launched. If I have room, I will link it underneath the cards. It's an old video that I kind of need to rewatch myself as well. I know that I liked the foundation then. I know that I liked it a lot. So I wanted to give it a go, to have a lighter option now for in summer and all that, you know? So yeah, is that it? Let's kind of stay in drugstore. Oh, I lied. I have another Revolution thingy. Let's stay in drugstore then. Let's go to Revolution because I got their clear brow gel. I like it. I don't like it as much. Unfortunately, my favorite one is still the Benefit. But Benefit isn't cruelty free. This is a very nice alternative though. The only thing what I have decided to do is the component that I have from Benefit, that wand, is so perfect. I'm going to, when the Benefit one runs out, I'm going to keep that wand and use that for my brows. Because the wand is just perfect. I can really squash it on my face. But this is very good. It keeps my brows in place. So I'm happy about that. Yeah, I don't really know what to say about it. Let's go next to NYX. I also got a lip pencil from NYX in the color Munchies. It's a pretty... It's such a gorgeous color. So yeah, I got that one as well. I haven't tried it yet. I just swatched it. I also got a few other brow products from MUA. The micro brow pencil that I use from MUA in gray isn't sold here in store anymore. I still can get it online, but not in store anymore, which is weird. So I thought, let me get a black. I don't know what I was thinking. Well, I kind of was thinking maybe I can do an ombre effect, or when my hair is a bit darker, I can kind of, you know, whatever. But what did they have? They had this one, and this is the Brow Define Eyebrow Pencil with Blending Brush. But it is a triangle one. I don't know if you can see. It's dirty. Yes, I used it. I like it. I actually didn't think I would like the triangle part because I always felt like that I couldn't be precise with it, but I actually can. And then here's the brush. I know that Catrice has something similar like this as well, that they don't have in store where I live, but they do have in store in Alkmaar. So maybe I will try one from Catrice as well to kind of compare. But so far I really like this. It's nice and creamy. It sets. Don't look at my brows too closely today because they're, I don't know, in a caterpillar mode. I don't know, people. I also got blushes, a cream blush. I'm really into the cream blushes, and I have already seen these in store a few months ago, and then I was like, yeah, I want to get into cream blushes, but I don't know. And now that I have some cream blushes, I was like, let me just try them. They have 6 shades. They had 4 shades in the store where I was, so I got all 4. So basically the only 2 shades that I don't have is kind of like maybe a more of a browner one and a dark berry one. So if I see those 2, I still do want to try them. Yeah. Okay, so I got watermelon. I also got misty rose. I got peach puff and tiger lily. So far I've only used watermelon and tiger lily. Tiger lily is so pretty. Watermelon is also gorgeous, but I can get overboard quickly. I do want to tell you how I use these though. What do? I actually put it a little bit on the back of my hand. I dab like that. Then I have a brush like this, which is a duo. It's just a round kind of a... This is actually from LOV. It is their blush. No, highlighter brush. But I love this for cream blush. And then I go like that. And then I kind of stipple it on the face, which maybe I shouldn't have done because I have my base on. But that is how I use it, and I build it up in light layers like this. This behaves like a stain, and it's so pretty. It stays on all day. It's, oh, they are already a favorite. What I am going to film, maybe tomorrow, I don't know when I'm going to film this, but that is my favorites of spring. You will probably see these. I think you will see some of the stuff that I'm mentioning today, which is kind of weird because I haven't been using them a lot. But yeah, if it's a favorite, sometimes you just know, you know? Let's next go, before I go to a high-end, almost forgot the brushes. Let's go to this, which is actually a false lashes tool set from Catrice in the sachet like that. It is a, why are you... open, yes, thank you. It is scissors, which are very, very nice, the scissors. And you get one of these things. And then this is actually a comb on one side. Can you see? Yes. And then a brush on the other side. This is very nice to use. It's very sturdy. This is also very sturdy. The only downside, though, is I need to kind of grip it very tightly or very shortly, because otherwise I get a cramp in my hands to, yeah. So I don't like this to apply my falsies with, because I have to hold it so close, you know. I do like it to kind of do that. So yeah, overall, yeah, it's okay. 3 out of 2 things that I like isn't bad. So yeah, it's all metal though, so it's not plasticky or anything. It's a nice quality. Okay, let's next go to, yeah, let's go like that. So let's go to high end then, because I did my first Sephora order. That's where I used the blushes for the first time, I think. I don't know. I filmed also my first Sephora order. It's these 3 products. It's the Milk Hydro Grip Primer that I have on my face again today. I got the mini because I didn't know if I liked it. So yeah, if you want to know my first impression, you gotta watch the video. Otherwise, this video will be way too long. I also got, because I'm really into cream products, I wanted to get a cream contour stick, and I didn't know which one, and people kept raving about this one, and I was like, you know what, fine. So I ordered the Fenty Match stick in the color Amber, which is very, very cool toned. It's almost purple. This would be cool on the lips as well, basically, actually. I swatched it against, in that first impression, I swatched it against my powder contour from Essence. When I really build up that powder contour shade, it's almost this shade. So for me, it's a perfect match. And I also wanted to try her setting powder. And this is in the color Butter. It's also a mini, but you get quite a lot of powder. And you don't need a lot. And it's just, I want to show you something.
it's just so cute. It's a mini. It's cute because it's tiny.
Never mind that. Yeah. Okay. So far, I really like the products that I hold from Sephora. And that was kind of a sneak peek. Still, you know, if you want to know more in-depth thoughts, watch that video. To be on the safe side, make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and the bell button so you will be notified when all the videos go online. Just a tip. I also got brushes. This video, me trying out my Sigma brush set, is online already. It went online Friday the 29th. I will link it if I have room. I think I have linked, maybe I have linked it already in the beginning. I don't know. But I got the ultimate, what's it called again? The ultimate blending brush set. You get 6 brushes. Spoiler alert, I love these brushes. If you are on the fence about this brush set, don't be, because it's worth it. You get the E42, the E44, that's these two. Then the other two, let's do the white ones. Let's start with the small one, that is the E27, and the bigger one is the E25. And then the last two are the E33 and the E38. Spoiler, the E33 is my fave. So yeah, very, very good quality brushes. Then the last thing that I... Yeah, you know, technically the cremated palette was also ordered in this month. But it isn't here yet, so I'm just going to mention it. Also, the new palette from 5050 Makeup, their summer palette, I ordered technically this month, but it will be here next month. I think this Monday or something, but that is technically the next month. So let's start, let's end with what I have on my face today as well, which is from VE Cosmetics, because my order from VE arrived yesterday. I ordered the Grimoire palette as kind of a dupe, or, well, not a dupe, an alternative for the cremated palette from Jeffree Star Cosmetics, and this one came out last year. This is what she looks like. This is what I have on my face today. So yeah, I am going to do, I don't think the videos are online, maybe they are, the first impression. I filmed it just today. I hope to have it online today or tomorrow as I'm filming this, which is Saturday. So if it is up, I will link it. Otherwise, it is coming very, very soon. I will do eye swatches. I will also do multiple looks. And when the cremated palette arrives, I will compare the two. Okay, so there's that. I also ordered 3 of her liquid lipsticks. Here they are. So on my lips today is the shade called Anarchy, which is a gray. And I tapped over one of the shades from the palette to give it a little bit of a sparkle. Then the color Demon is more of a... I thought it was a very deep dark brown, but it's actually a very, very deep dark brown red. Very pretty, very vampy look. And then here I have the color Rune, which is a little bit more of a cooler tone brown. So far, the formula feels nice. It doesn't feel crumbly. I thought it would maybe be a little bit crumbly, but it doesn't feel crumbly. It's very comfortable. However, I want a lip mask underneath. Just saying. And then she sent me in PR the Witchcraft blush book. And I was just speechless. So, let me... And there also came a brush. I haven't used the brush, but I did use one of the blushes. The blush I used today was... Where is it? This one? This one? The pans are huge, they feel very soft. There are some true matte shades in here, but most of them are satiny, shimmery. I love a shimmery blush. So the blush that I have on my face today is a little bit lighter of a color, but I can kind of go a little bit more ham with it, you know. So yeah, so far I really, really like it, but I only used it today, and the blush book I'm going to use in my multiple looks video as well, so I can really test it out, you know. But that is everything that I hauled this month. Oh wow, I kept it under half an hour filming. Wow. That was it for my haul of May. Let me know down below if you have any of the products. Maybe, I don't know, you have some tips and tricks that you feel work for you. I wanted to say something else, I think. I just don't really know what. But yeah, that was basically it, guys. I am just going to stop filming today and enjoy the weather, eat a little bit, drink some coffee and edit a video. And I think I'm going to visit my dad. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.